because
he's he's 26 years old. Okay, game is starting, and his opponent is playing with white is Andrei Tolchikov from Belarus. And he's also a very young player. He's even younger than Robert. He's only 22 years old. Okay, I will describe a little bit situation in the tournament, explain you which tournament is playing today, because it's not normal tournament, it's Blitz. It means that players get not a lot of time for the thinking. Each one is getting only 5 minutes for a game, and for each making move they get 3 seconds extra. So they have to play very fast, and they cannot think a lot, because even they will have good position, they could lose because of time. So in the Blitz game, the time is more important than in normal games. Okay, it's only opening. And I describe you the situation in the tournament. It's already 11 rounds they're playing, and Tolchikov, young player from Belarus, he has not good situation in the tournament. He lost already 3 games and won only 2. So he is in the second part of a tournament table, and for him in this game it's not so important maybe result, so he can play more open way and to allow himself some more risk, because even he will lose one more game, it cannot be a big problem for him. And Robert Misans, his opponent, which is playing with black, he also has lost one game, but only one, and he won 2, so he has plus 1, and totally it's 11 points. So his situation a little bit better, but also not so well. They're not leading in the tournament, and actually Robert Misans is only on the 10th place. So he also can allow himself some interesting game. And we all are expected for this. Okay. Now they made about 10-15 moves already, so the opening part of the draft game is close to finish, and we are going to the second part of the draft. It's middle game. Some players thinking that this part of a game is the most important. It's decisive part, because not so important how you started your opening and everything could be changed soon in the middle. The position can turn over, and before white had advantage, for example, and soon can be changed. And okay, now let's see our game, because we can discuss already something. What we have on the board. Black has a side piece on the 25. Yes, and actually in drafts it's not good to go to side and to occupy side fields. It's better to occupy central fields. But sometimes it's possible also to use this strategy and play also on the side fields. As I said before, they both are very young players, so they may be rising stars. And especially Robert Misans, he is very good in playing blitz, but maybe this tournament he play not so well. Of course, so many strong players, many grandmasters, many champions, and they both, Tolchikov and Misans, they are not grandmasters. They're still international masters. Okay. And the game is close to classical type of the game. But with some difference that there is side piece on the 25. So I think it is small advantage for black. And also white has some backward, some idle piece on the 50. I can explain you the situation in the tournament. In the main tournament there are 16 players and they play Rabin system. So now we are on the round 11, so they played already 10 rounds. And Guntis Valder is from Latvia, the same country as Misans Roberts, is leading in this tournament, and he won 5 games, haven't lost anyone, and has 15 points. Only 1 point less is Alexander Balyakin from Holland. He won 4 games and also hasn't lost anyone, so he has 14 points. And some sensational situation, 2 African players, Jean-Marc Jofang and Flaubert Ndonzi, they are on the 3rd and 4th place. Jofang, and they both won 4 games, but Jofang lost 1 and Donzi lost 2. But it's big surprise, because behind of them champions, also Blitz World champions, Alexander Schwarzman, Alexei Chizhov from Russia. Of course, it's only 10 round, but already it's a sensation. Robert Misson's made an exchange and he went to side, occupied the field 30. He's trying to confine white position a little bit. But for example, if white wants, they can force simplification in the position. Example to attack 40-35 and after that black has to change. White is thinking. Maybe it is important moment for white now. They have to choose some way how to continue develop their pieces. Robert don't let to white to change to center, but you see the situation is changing on the board very fast. So before some moment we had one position, after few moves it changed. Now you see it's not look like so bad for white. I think it's better for them now. They develop all pieces, build columns, and now yes, now no problems for white. Now it's slight advantage for them. You see, white now control over three central fields: 27, 28, 29. And especially in 100 international drafts, it is very important to control center. They're changing pieces. So obviously this game is going to finish to draw, because left only six pieces, equal amount, and you know that in drafts if you lost even one piece, it could be losing position, so yeah, the game is almost over. But everything can happen because it's Blitz, and so they don't have enough time, and maybe they can make some mistakes, but I don't think so. It has to be a draw, yes. So from the opening it looked like it could be interesting game, but finally in the middle players changed all pieces and it finished. a draw. So the game is over. It was not long game. But what we can do? Okay, we are gone. Now it's the next round of the Blitz tournament. 12 rounds. And this round we have the match between Gantwar against Virney. Gantwar is playing with white. He's on the left side of you, and against him is Vadim Virney from Germany. Anatoly Gantwar is from Belarus. Both are grandmasters, top level players. Gantwar, he is 64 years old, and Vadim Virney is 47. Gantwar is the oldest player of this tournament. He is a veteran, and he was 4 times world champion, but it was so far in the past. Last time he got this title in 1985, so you see some of participants of this tournament haven't born still. And his opponent Vadim Virney also is a very strong player, but actually, he couldn't achieve the world champion title. He was only second. He played match against Dutch world champion, the champion from the Netherlands, very famous player Harm Wiersma, and he finished this match in draw, so he couldn't be the champion. Now we can see what is happening on the board, and we have classical position. Classical type of position, it means when white and black pieces are standing on the main line. Piece 32-28 against 23-19. It is not very sharp kind of positions in draft, and Vadim Virney is very experienced in these positions. He likes them to play because he don't have so much risk. Okay, time is going. You see, four minutes has Anatoly Gantwar, and 3 minutes 49 seconds for Vadim Virney. And after each making move, they get 3 seconds extra. don't have any more classical position. Yes, black changed and went out from this kind of the position, but it's still close to classic, so it's also quiet, and you cannot give advantage for anyone. A little ugly, awkward construction black has on their right, on their left hand flank. I mean, column from the pieces 15, 20, 24, but it's not a big problem. And soon the position can be reached again to the classical one. And tell you some interesting information from the last round. In last round, Gantwarg lost the game against African player Flaber Ndonzi, and his opponent Vadim Virny, he won. He beat the leader of the tournament, Guntis Valneris, and so at that moment Vadim Virny has 14 points, and he's close to leaders. Maybe he's dividing third place, not sure. And Gantwarg, after losing a game, he's in the middle of the tournament table, so they have different aims, maybe. Now interesting situation on the board. Vadim Virny made the invasion on the field 29, you see, and Anatoly Gantwarg cannot attack this piece because of simple combination. After that he will lose a piece, and also he cannot change immediately this piece 29 because of simple exchange, and after that black again will win a piece. So he has to find something, maybe to play 37-31. But in this case, so many pieces he will get on his left flank. So we can state that, yes, he played 37-31. The advantage is exactly on the black side. About time. Vadim Virny now has 3 minutes. He's thinking, and Anatoly Gantwarg has 1 minute less. Okay, they made small exchange, and now Gantwarg got the piece on 22, but this one is not so strong as had Vadim Virny. And black could try to isolate this piece, maybe. No. Now black has a choice. They can go 12-18, but after that white will continue with 31-26, and after will could change backward 27-21, and position simple, yes, but or it was the second possibility. Yes, and now they both have this outpost, Gunfar and Virni. And Virni, maybe he's trying to win, yeah, so he made this move because he's fighting for first places, at least for first three. So he doesn't want to change pieces and Roy is not enough for him. And now interesting moment that Vadim Virni cannot play 1924 because of simple combination. So Akin, in that case, White can give 38-33 after weight and took four pieces. Yes, of course he found this. What about time now? On the Gunvar's clocks left a little more than 1 minute, and Virni has more time. He has almost 2 minutes, and Gunvar is sinking. So situation is very sharp on the board, and it's not clear how it could be finished. Gunvar is keeping the idea and don't allow for black to play 1923, 1924, and so Vadim Virni closed the hole on the 8. Active move, and now Vadim Virni wants to attack the piece 22 from the field 17. So now the piece 22 is in danger. What's the idea of this move? Yes, Vadim is attacking. Gunvar has to sacrifice a piece, and he is trying to get it back soon, but I'm not sure that he could do it. And you see, he has only 11, now 14 seconds, big advantage in a time for Vadim Virni. Yes, and time is extremely important in blitz. So now only the question, will win this game Vadim or not? No chances to win the game for White, because one piece more for black now, and white should think how to get it back. But Vadim spent a lot of time, and now They have almost the same amount combination. Combination made by Vadim Virni. And they are going to endgame. And in this endgame, 2 seconds, 5 seconds, in this endgame, White now reached to a king, and black has big advantage with the pieces. interesting situation. Oh, something wrong happened on the board, and now this endgame with big chances to win for black, but of course problem with the time. Yeah, they both have a king, but black has two pieces more. Of course that's a big advantage, but in 100 drafts you have to have four kings to win. So if Vadim will lose even one more piece, it will be draw. So you see Anatoly trying to attack pieces, and yes, so he defends the. Okay, we are going on, and now we have the match between Alexander Georgiev, the current world champion, but in a normal time control game. He is playing with black, and he is on the right of you. And his opponent is Robert Misans. You followed already one game of the Roberts. Robert Misans is playing with white. And this tournament, Alexander Georgiev started not so well. He even lost one game. But he still has chances for the first places, so it is 13th round. And I think for Roberts it's already not so important. He's in middle of the tournament table. And in previous round Alexander Georgiev beat another leader, Jean-Marc Chofang from Cameroon. So he is in a good mood, and he is trying to win again. Now we can follow the game, and already we can see which position, which type of positions each one try to play, and Alexander Georgiev, because he is playing for win, he tried to win, so you see he gave to his opponent almost every scene. Robert control all central fields of the board, and but of course if you want to win, you cannot change pieces, you should play something special. Of course with some risk. Without risk you cannot win. And you see now, interesting moment. I think Robert understands that Georgia will not change pieces, and so he can. He is making this move, and now. Now, for example, if Georgia will play 21-27, give one, take two. No, he didn't. One more central field for Misans, and now you see he control over four central fields, 27, 28, 29, 30, and another strong field on the 23. So I don't know which counter play. Oh, sacrifice. Interesting sacrifice is making by Georgiev. You see, he gave a piece, and you know that in droughts capturing is mandatory, so white hasn't a choice. They had to capture this piece, and now white has one piece more. But black is trying to organize a breakthrough on the left white flank. Very interesting situation. Oh, and finally Georgiev is taking the piece back. See, and with equal amount of pieces, it will be easily winning position for the black, because amount of pieces is equal, but the left flank of white is very weak, and they cannot bring some pieces on that side. Important that no piece on the field 47, so black just has to wait and after bring more pieces to this side, and after give one, and the piece 36 will be going to king. Now I think is winning position for black. But of course it's blitz, and you never know. Georgiev is thinking, he's calculating variants, and yes, of course he wants to win, and he took backward, and it's more safety, because when you're trying to attack to organize a breakthrough on the opponent flank, you should to be sure that the opponent will not attack your flank. Misans invades on the opponent's territory, but I think it cannot help him. And even he can lose maybe second piece. In this case, it will be absolutely losing position for him. But of course, he cannot stop to play. He should continue. The plan of the black is simple. Yes, they just go into the left win of the white, and try and to organize a breakthrough. After that, they will get a king, and as you understand, the king is very important in drafts, and if you can estimate, one king is maybe the same as three pieces, because king can move so far, and also you can use him for combination, so it has to be winning position for black. What about time? Alexander Georgiev has 2 minutes and Robert Misson's 3 and 27 seconds, so Misson is trying to make some pressure using the time, but I think it is enough to win, but I don't know why Georgiev is thinking. Of course he is afraid to miss something and don't win this game, because after not very nice beginning of the tournament, in the previous rounds he won few games, and so now he's close to the prize places. White has a lot of pieces in the middle of a board in center, but they has the problem that they cannot solve. It is weak left wing. Okay, already Alexander Georgiev has less than 1 minute. Okay, this time is come. And okay, he's attacking. Now he can make a king, and it will be winning position for him. So now it's time to think in for Misson's. He has a lot of time. He has more than almost 3 minutes, but if position is losing, about what he could think? Because as I mentioned before, the king is extremely strong in drafts. Next move, Alexander Georgiev can make a king, and I think yes, on the field 47, it's safety. No, he attack immediately the piece, and now. Oh, now interesting if the white will play 29-23, because yes, now king wants to capture more white pieces, and after that I think Georgiev prepared some combination. Maybe we'll be lucky to see this combination. And you can estimate the real force of a king. Misson's trying to play one move after another. Yes, now he also only 1 minute has. What he can do? Position is losing for him absolutely, so he only maybe has some practical chances to continue to defend, but now we have to give 14-19. No, it's combination, so the game is continuing and Roberts continue to defend. Georgiev made two moves and now his position is safe and now he wants to attack the piece 21, you see, and because in this endgame he has one piece less, he has king but one piece less, but if he will win this piece and with equal amount of pieces it will be absolutely winning position. Okay. Now Misson's gave it by himself. Now just a question how to realize the advantage because of time. 8-7 seconds for Georgiev. Oh, something interesting. Some combination. Oh, now you can estimate the king. Now understand what is the king, yes. How you can use it. Small combination and the king, yes, and Misson's have to resign. Yes, brilliant game. Winning with Georgiev. Congratulations for him. Okay, stand on with us. Continue our broadcasting from the Beijing, from the second World Mind Games, and we have the Blitz tournament in drafts today. It's not the main event will start soon. Today it's the Blitz. Blitz, it means when players are getting less time than normal game. They have 5 minutes and per each making move they will get 3 seconds extra. And we are following the match between Alexey Chizhov from Russia and his opponent is Vadim Virny from Germany. Alexey is playing with black and Vadim with white. They're only starting their opening. And Alexey Chizhov, it's a real legend from the Russia. He's 10 times world champion. Normal drafts game, official time control. Now it's Blitz. But they both are very strong players, strong grandmasters. position is not very sharp now on the board. Vadim is not against draw, I think. He respects his opponent. Now they have some changes on the board. And of course, after this changes, position is becoming more simple. But Chizhov is winning more tempos, yes. So he's becoming closer to center of the board, and so this can give him more benefit in the future. And Virna is trying to defend also. Virna got the piece on the side, 26. It's also minus of his position. And I think Chizhov is trying to win, because maybe he has less points than other players on the top of tournament. But anyway, Chizhov is playing in positional manner, also with smallest amount of risk. Yeah, they change pieces. Now Chizhov maybe has to attack 25. Yes, because he had to develop the piece on 5, but it brings to the game more simplifications. It is 14th round, and next round is the last, so it is too close to the end of the tournament. And both players are on the top, so they both fighting for the first places. Now Virny has piece on 29, central piece, and he's trying to support this piece with columns to neutralize the weakness of his side piece. The game is going in a very quiet way. Maybe both players have not so strong opponents in the last round. And so they're expecting to win. Yes, in the last round, Vadim Virny should to play against Alan Silva from Brazil, who is going in the end of the tournament table, and Chizhov will play against Donzi, who is playing very well, but it's possible to beat him. Chizhov is winning 4 temps. Anyway, his position is slight better, but they're both positional players, so I suppose this game will finish in draw, but of course, black position is more maneuvering, so they can do something also, they can organize some counterplay against the piece 29, yes. And Vadim has some problems how to develop. Yes, he continues to change pieces. If they will go in this way, it will be draw for sure. No one has weaknesses, so position is almost equal. Maybe a little more beautiful. It looks like for black, but just a little. And this time also, is everything okay for boss? Chizhov has an advantage with the time. 1 minute more he has. Only 7 against 7 left on the board now, only 6 against 6. Chizhov will try to surround a little bit to organize his game against the piece 28. Only one central piece of white, but so small amount of pieces, so I think it will be draw. The style of the players is very similar. They both play almost the same way.